Hey guys, how's it going? Sorry I haven't been very active lately, but I've got a new purchase. I purchased it pretty much on this to the same day, 1 year anniversary of when I purchased that Bachmann Henry, on Black Friday. This is a purchase I got from eBay after seeing Project Tiger Moth. It was another one of those spontaneous purchases, although this one was much more expensive. What's this purchase, you're probably all wondering? Well, let's go find out. Alright, well, here he is. Let's see if I can get him in focus. I'm using a wide-angle lens for the first time. There we go. Yeah, sorry the lighting isn't that good, but as you can see, it's a Festiniog Railway Prince N scale. It's about, or I'm sorry, not N scale, 009 scale, which, is basically the same as N scale, but it's, the same track size, but, it's supposed to, the dimensions are supposed to match HO, or 00 for you British people. It looks like it's made by Kato, which is a Japanese company. That's where I got the chassis, motorized chassis for Horace from. Surprisingly, for some reason, when I bought this, I was pretty sure I was buying Princess, which is another one of these English, George England types, but honestly, it doesn't really matter because, I mean, this is technically the basis for Duke, so yeah, it doesn't really matter. Princess is just a brighter red, and, yeah, so, here's my hand, kind of a size comparison. I'll show you a more detailed view later. But, yeah, this is it in his box. It's so ironic. I bought this off eBay, thinking it was something you could only get in the UK, or I guess Japan, because it's Kato. Yet, literally, right on this day, today, I went to my local train shop, and I saw this exact locomotive for sale. It was around the same price. I'll get to the pricing in a minute, but, so ironic, I could have just bought it here. That's the equivalent of, like, buying a rare Japanese, what, Bandai Tex, or, I don't know, are they Japanese? It's the equivalent of buying something like that online, because you think you can only get it in Japan, and then the same day it arrives, you go into a shop and see it for sale in new condition. Like, that's how crazy that is. But, yeah, 009. Let's take him out, see how he runs. Okay, so I've switched to my phone because this model is so small, it's really difficult to get it in focus with my camera. But yeah, so Prince is now out of his box. First thing you'll probably notice is the cab seems to be loose, and the I can't tell if that's an intentional thing, because, these engines, when they were first built, they didn't have cabs, kind of like Scarlowe and Tallyclin. Come to think of it, I don't think it's intentional, because I see all these holes where it's supposed to slot in, but that's easily fixable, I'm sure. The whistle also seems to have come off. I don't think that's intentional. Yeah, I don't think that's intentional. Definitely not. But it seems like it just slots right in. The only problem is, it's so small, I can't really do it without my glasses. I mean, oh, you know what? I know what happened. Because the cab is loose, the whistle came out. Oh, that's a bit annoying. But again, this is easily fixable. I can just have to fiddle around with it. But yeah, as I said before, this model is tiny. Let me just see if I can. This is my finger. And yeah, so it's, you can see like how small this model is. And the tender, I'm actually noticed, it looks like you can't take it off unless you unscrew it. Probably can't see it there. Oh yeah, there's a screw to take off, if you wanted to separate it. That's not like most locomotives where, you can just, it just has like a hook you put it on, and I think that's actually kind of clever, so you doesn't separate from it. But yeah, this is a, let me turn them around so you can see the front. Wow, this is a beautiful locomotive. I'm just shocked at the amount of detail. Now I'm starting to realize why smaller models like this aren't necessarily cheaper than, you know, an HO or 00 model. I mean, they must have some very sophisticated technology. Like, did they use molds, 3D printing? The rods, you know, are bright red, you know, like the real locomotive. Wow, there's, you can't really see it, but there's even glass or plastic in the cab windows. That's some crazy detail. I'll talk about the price of this at the end of the video, but I'll just say it was not cheap. Let's give Prince some tests, and let's see if he runs on the track. Okay, so I've taken Prince out, put him on the track, and I've put Horace in front of him. And can you guys spot the immediate problem? Oh, aside from the derailment. Aside from that, can you spot the immediate problem? Yeah, the size is completely different. I mean, Horace completely dwarfs Prince. It, you know, because, you know, Horace is supposed to be, you know, it's a similar model to Peter Sam, so... But when you put Peter Sam next to Duke, they don't look anything like this. They're on the same size, so... I'm very confused. Because, you know, these both fit on N-scale track. They're both marked as 009 scale. I guess my question is, well, first off, I can't tell where this model was made. There was an address in Schaumburg, Illinois, but then again, there was also one in the UK, so... You know, it's a UK engine. Maybe it wasn't. So the only thing I can think of is, if it's an American-made engine... HO's the American scale, 00 is a British version. They both use the same size track, but, you know, British 00 is big. The engines are bigger, so I'm wondering, because 009 is supposed to match the, you know, it's N scale, but, you know, the scale itself, like the people, I'll put it that way, the people are supposed to be the same size as 00, or... I'm wondering if, because this is an American engine, you know, it's HO scale, whereas the, you know, I got the 3D print from Horace from the UK, so that's the only thing I can figure. It's not the end of the world. I mean, they still look, you know, people who can ride, you know, people who could fit in Prince could, or I mean, in Horace could probably fit in Prince, but yeah, it's a very noticeable size difference. I'm going to try to show you what a real N-scale thing looks like. So this is an N-scale coach. It's some Milwaukee coach I got from a... It was like, you know, a used one they had in a local hobby store. But as you can see, you know, the people who would fit in this, in a Horace, would not fit in this. It's completely different scale. But again, they use the same track. I bought this carriage with the intent to, like, you know, take the bogies off and turn it into a 009 scale track, but I think I'll keep it. You know, I've ordered some more bogies, the 009 bogies, so, I'm sorry, N-scale bogies, so I'll probably just custom make any coaches I use, but I don't really know what to say. Kind of a more in-detail view. Yeah, it's like he's, it's like that scene, I forget what season it's from, but... You know, the infamous one where Duck and Oliver came head-to-head, and, you know, one of them was completely out of scale. Well, that's like this. Duke and Peter Sam. Like, that's all I'm really thinking. Yeah, well, aside from the scaling issues, you know, they both fit the track fine. Yeah, let's do some tests with Prince. Let's see how he runs. Okay, so I've got him on the tracks. Now I'm gonna see if he works. I'm just trying to adjust this camera. It's really hard to get good lighting, as you can see. But, yeah. All right. See if he works. And he does. He runs really smoothly, too. I'm not used to locomotives running this smoothly, because when I was a kid, most of the model trains I... Most of the model trains I had were all secondhand. You know, they were either from my dad, who had them, like, in the 70s, or, you know, they were secondhand from eBay. And honestly, given the price of these things, I don't blame my dad for buying them off eBay. But, yeah, sorry, the lighting's really bad here. I'm just trying to see if I can get a better view of him. That's slightly better. Anyway, so... here he is, Prince. See, is that good enough for you guys? Wow, just, this thing is just so detailed. I don't even want to try any major stunts with him. You know what, I might as well do one. Let's see how fast he can go. Hope if I turn the power on. Let's see what his top speed is. Yeah, he derailed. Not completely, but his bogey came off. Again, this model's so delicate, I don't even want to try any major stunts with him. As for the same reason, I don't want to, like... oh, what's the word? You know what I mean. I don't want to, like, turn him into Duke or anything. I mean, it's just such an expensive model and so delicate. I just don't think it's worth the amount I paid to, like, redo him. Yeah, I'll get into the price in a minute, but yeah, he runs really smoothly. Better than Horace. Yeah, you guys can see, sorry, bad view, but just look how detailed that is. But he runs, so yeah, I mean, that's all I'm really asking for. Locomotive looks good, and he runs. Okay, and here are just some general updates on Horace. I decided to give him some more paint, just, you know, painting some more of his features. And, you know, using hand brush had pretty bad results when I tried it with his whistle. And, you know, airbrush, it just seems it's too small for to really get a good job with that. But I found these interesting in-between options. They're basically markers, but with enamel paint. And when I say that, I mean they're not just like Sharpies. They actually have real paint in them. Again, these aren't perfect, but they're really, if you get like the right size, it's really easy, you know, to do very small jobs. This is kind of out of order, but here you can see me painting, you know, the front of Horace, you know, all these handles. And next time, yeah, I would probably use masking tape, but as you can see, I got one with such a small point that, you know, it just easily, you know, paints on like that. You know, the three colors I got were black, gold, and not shown here, but also a red one, which I haven't had to use yet. But the black one was very useful because, as you all probably remember, Horace got pretty damaged in my suitcase. And so this works really well. It's kind of like a touch-up. I wouldn't recommend painting a whole engine with these, obviously, but as you can see, it's a very nice, simple way to touch up, you know, scratches and marks. The black, I'm pretty pleased with. The gold, as you can see, is not the greatest. It's really hard to find good masking tape, but, yeah, I have very shaky hands. But, yeah. You basically shake the, again, you shake the markers, and you have to press it down a few times before the paint comes out. And then, you know, you just let it dry like regular paint. So yeah, guys, sorry this was a long video, but, yeah, I hope you all guys have a good holiday season. As you all know, the 10th anniversary of my channel is coming up soon, and I'll be uploading something on that day. So, you know, keep your eyes open for that. I'll also be uploading more of the scenery videos. I just thought, you know, this video would be too long if I put them in here. But, yeah, I've been working on that too. So, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.